The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boise State's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
There he goes. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40.
Go! 2 and 8! To go!
Quick pass, and down he goes,
right around the 24-yard line.
Well, the defense was completely out of position. I think the play action really opened things up that time. They completely bit up, thought the running back had the football, and the quarterback had a wide open receiver to make that throw downfield.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Quickly.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
Go!
Brought down right around the 22-yard line.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
From the 22-yard line, third down. And he might want it all here, and does! Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance. But that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Boise State is looking to go up by 3. He gets it up, and he's got it. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They bring him down in the backfield.
He just timed the snap count there and really made a nice play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 26.
10-2!
Bring him down at the 38.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
Makes it out to about the 46. A gain of 8 on the carry. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Takes the counter left. And he's level at the 48.
They picked a good time to go with that call. It didn't seem like the defense was ready for it. And they'll move the chains.
He heaves it deep. In and out of his hands. From the 48-yard line. It's second down. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 9-7.
49-yard line.
That brings us fourth and 11. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position of this football game. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. They're ready to begin another drive. Boise State holds a field goal lead. Tries to get around the corner. Nice run there as they work the outside. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Into that quickly, and he tackles him hard at the 42.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 42-yard line, second down, in the shotgun and five wideouts. Has all day to throw. He's tackled
right around the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
Boise State is up by 3. Here's a throw. I don't think he got anything on that.
Well, that's one of those plays where the wide receiver is expected to make something happen after the reception, but the defense wasn't giving up anything.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Tackle made right around the 30.
Gain of 7 yards.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Fires to the wideout. First down. He's taken down around the 12-yard line.
First down.
We've played one. The Broncos lead 3-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2.
Go!
And he hits him hard at the 4-yard line.
That's a deep hit on the play. That makes it something into 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Touchdown.
PAT. An 11-play, 79-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. There he goes. There's a fumble. They fall on it. And he's taken down around the 43-yard line.
Once the ball hits the ground, it's a matter of luck and will. And on that play, it was the defensive end who corralled it for his side.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Makes the grab and steps out right away. From the 30-yard line, first down. He's at the 20. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Tackle at about the 19-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 19. Play fake. Quick throw. And they make the stop at the 9.
Makes the reception. Gain of 10 yards. That brings up second and 1.
They go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. Now it's 1st and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain.
Gain of 9 yards. That makes it 1st and goal.
Defense stacked in tight here. Makes a move and he's in for the touchdown.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. Tackle at the 19.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
It's still only the 2nd quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout.
Blue 14.
Throws completely stopped immediately. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Makes it out to about the 43.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Red 2, 3, 9.
tackled at the 49.
The draw play to the running back gives him 8 or 9 yards.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Action throws this one out to the left. This one will fall incomplete.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
Run right and hit the backfield. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D.
Red two, orange three, orange three. Go! Go! Go!
They try to get a head start there.
False start, offense. Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Flare!
He really got a hold of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected, and now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back in the first half and you think about, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack him. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances and be more aggressive in trying to put pressure on him.
What they've done so far hasn't worked. And down he goes at the 16. The Beavers are going to call their second timeout from their own 16-yard line. Third down. He gets to about the 27-yard line. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's tackled at the 32-yard line.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. They bring him down.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. Boise State's lead is 17.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. The first half was a complete mismatch. We did not expect a margin like this. Now the question becomes, not only are you down on the scoreboard, David, but you're down mentally. What kind of toll does a beating like this team took in the first half have on your psyche?
Well, when you come into a game and you're favored or it's supposed to be a really close contest and then all of a sudden you start getting kicked around, I think the first thing is, do I belong? Am I really as good as I thought I was? And they got a second half to come out and prove it. But right now, they've had no answers whatsoever. Everything has gone the other way. Everything's gone poorly. Everything's gone bad. So if they're going to turn this around, they better start believing that they belong and come out in the second half and start making some plays.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollock can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Broncos continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Good gain by the tailback of about 7 on the option play. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
It's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
Second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. A 1 yard gain by the halfback.
Boy, this senior safety provides such solid run support. He stopped him in his tracks that time. Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
You knew that return was doomed as soon as he put his hands on the ball. With the field as messy as it is, he wasn't going anywhere.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here.
Ball on the 19-yard line.
He's out of bounds around the 21-yard line.
Call to give you 2 yards. That'll bring up 32.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
Call it a gain of 7 yards.
First and 10.
Ball on the 28.
And still completed it. They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line.
That's a smart call to exploit the pass rush and open up some space for him. The blockers did a good job of selling that play.
Get to that quickly. He's tackled at the 49-yard line.
Number four makes the tackle at the 49-yard line.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Around the 49-yard line. And that one goes for about 2 yards and first down.
I'll tell you, these guys just keep rolling down the field. Quarterback's looking very sharp on this drive.
is immediately tackled. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. They run left and he'll lose yardage. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. He goes out of bounds at the 32.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's at the 20. He gets out to about the 14-yard line.
First down.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive.
Here we go.
Quick shot, the defender tips it away.
Excellent pass defense. You've got to be able to make a lightning quick reaction to bat the ball away like he did right there.
From the 14-yard line, second down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Number
16. 13th play of the drive coming up. To his receiver, touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Boise State is lining up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boise State's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
He's taken down around the 31-yard line. They'll get 6 yards.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Made around the 40-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
We head to the fourth. 24-0, Boise State. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. And he's taken down at the 50. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Room around the corner. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 45. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45.
Great two.
30-yard line. First down. Throws complete. He's got space to work.
This is smart, efficient play call. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. The stop around the 12-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive.
Go 4-3-9.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Three down.
Green eye.
Motion.
He steps out at the 3-yard line. Here's the 11th play of the drive. To his receiver, touchdown.
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a 2-point conversion. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Slings it. He's got the 2. So under 3 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, and the score is Boise State 24, Oregon State 8. Tackle at the 44-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. The halfback picks up a yard. From the 43-yard line, second down. The middle for a nice game. The Beavers will use their first time out of the half. He's got it with room to run. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, first down.
Go!
Makes it out to about the 20. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Quick pass. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Just under 2 to go in the game.
Run.
the 19. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Is up, and they tack on 3 points. The Broncos and their team pretty happy with that field goal, but I think you got to give credit to the quarterback.
Well, I think you got to go back to the drive. The kick was clutch, but I think what the quarterback did and the offense did was even more impressive.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That's a loss of 5 yards. That'll bring up second and 15.
Spikes the ball.
That makes it third and 15.
From their own 20-yard line. It's third down.
Tight, right. Four down. Mike 13.
Black five. Blue 20.
Let's go.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And down he goes at about the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of 7. That makes it fourth and 8.
The ball.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. And the ball game's over, and our final score in this one, Boise State 27, Oregon State 8. So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.